Hello dear friends, we are going to learn now common collector amplifier. What is the meaning of common collector amplifier? Collector will be common for the signal, AC signal. Between the input signal and output signal, it is a grounded. So it is common collector amplifier or grounded collector amplifier. It is also known as emitter follower circuit. That means output we are taking from the emitter. You can see that here in the circuitry, this is the emitter terminal. Output we are taking from this emitter. Emitter bypass capacitor is not here. That means AC signal is not going to be bypassed through that one, but it is working as a coupling capacitor here, and we are taking the output from that one. What is the advantage of common collector amplifier? Its input impedance is very, very large. Output impedance is going to be zero, and it is actually ideal. Output impedance should be zero or it should be less, and its gain is less than one. Voltage gain is always less than one. Current gain is very large. Here we are normally measuring the voltage gain. So that is the reasons we are going to study. First of all, the frequency response. This is the RB resistance which is giving the bias. Now remember, in a journal, you are going to prepare a circuitry from this board. This circuit you are going to draw in your journal. Circuit which I have sent with the file, you don't draw it, but you draw the circuitry from this one. And one more thing I would like to tell you all the friends, that please buy one journal from the nearby place of your stationery shop, and from that journal you can start writing with each practicals. I am also going to upload within a next week or something regarding the readings of each practical, and from that you can copy down the readings, you can prepare a graph, you can prepare a calculations, etc., and you will be having a readings, you will be having a graph, you will be having a circuit diagram, you know the methodology and everything. So the journal you can prepare by yourself, and when the exams comes, maybe physically exam may be taken after Diwali or something, and we don't know, but it is possible that you may have to appear offline examination in the practical. So at that time, that journals is required for the entry in the lab, and for the journal marks will be counted. So remember these things. So this is the requirements. What I have done right now, you can see that at the input I have connected AFO. I have given the power supply as a VCC. 12 volt power supply is given for this practical. That is, a VCC is given, positive terminal. This is a negative terminal. BC108 is the transistor is here. NPN transistor is there. This is working as a coupling capacitor between these two. This is your AC millivolt meter. Yesterday for the FAT amplifier, I have shown you everything regarding the AC millivolt meter and AFO. So what we are doing right now? First, we'll adjust 1 kilohertz frequency, and because the gain is less than 1, we are not keeping the input voltage of normally 20 millivolt, but we are keeping the input voltage of 100 millivolt or something. 100 millivolt means it is considered to be 0.1 volt. So that is the amplitude we are going to keep here. So first we'll be measuring the amplitude at the input side. So I am connecting this meter, AC millimeter, with the input side, with the circuit connected. Remember, it should be connected with the circuit, and then you have to measure here. This is the input side. I have connected the AF also, as well as the meter also. And you can see in the meter, the range of the meter I have kept 100 millivolt, and this meter on the top, it is showing from 0 to 10, that is the top range, it shows the full scale deflection, that is going to be 100 millivolt. So I can adjust this one, I can vary this one, I can reduce also. I am changing this level of the AFO, that means I can change the amplitude, and I will adjust the amplitude such that the input voltage is going to be 100 millivolt, almost 100 millivolt. That is for 1 kilohertz frequency. Now I am putting this probe at the output. So I will be measuring the output voltage for this frequency 1 kilohertz, what will be the output voltage will be there. Now you can see that voltage has reduced. It is in the same range of 100 millivolt, but voltage has reduced from 100 millivolt to approximately something, you can say that 70 millivolt or something, isn't it? It is at the 7 pointer. So it shows that 70 millivolt is the output. So output voltage is 70 millivolt and input voltage is 100 millivolt. So the ratio of the two, that means output upon input, that is called voltage gain, that is going to be 70/100, that comes out to be 0.7. So it is less than 1 volt, less than 1. So gain in a common collector is always less than 1. Now what you have to do? You have to change the input frequency, because we need first the frequency response curve. So input frequency you have to change from, again, 20 hertz, 30 hertz, it is in a logarithmic scale. So 20 hertz, 30 hertz, then 50 hertz, then 100 hertz, 200, 300, then 500, then 1000, that is called 1K. Similarly, 2K, 3K, 5K, 10K, then 20K, 30K, then 50K, 100K, then 200K, 300K. Like that way, you have to vary this frequency using this probe. This may be 10K is going to be there. And you can see that it's still reduced. The gain is going to be still reduced, nearly 40 millivolt or something. So you can even increase this, lower this frequency. This is showing 120K frequency, and the gain is going to be less than that. It is only 28 millivolt or something output voltage. So divide by 100 millivolt, so 0.28 gain will be there. That means the gain is reduced from 0.7 to 0.28, less than 50%. And that way, the bandwidth you can find out. F1 and F2 you can find out, that is output voltage upon root 2. Or you can multiply by 0.707, and that way you will be having a two points, which is called upper cutoff point and lower cutoff point, where between that, whatever the frequency is going to be intercept, that is F2 and F1, and difference of these two frequency, F2 minus F1, which is called delta F bandwidth, that is usable area of the frequency over which you can utilize this amplifier. So this way, the frequency response can be studied for any kind of amplifier. Here we have taken a common collector. Previously, we have studied about the FET amplifier. FET was voltage control device. This transistor is a current control device. Everything you know about this thing. Both are having very high input impedance. So in that case, it is better. But in a FET amplifier, the gain was 7 to 10. But here, the gain is less than 1. That is the difference between these two. Remember. Okay. Now the second part of this one we are going to study is the input resistance and output resistance. How to measure the input resistance of the amplifier and how to measure the output resistance of the amplifier. So it is the next